At its basics, AI, artificial intelligence, is really the science of training machines to think and sometimes act like humans. What's interesting about AI is that it's been around for a long time. The AI of the past was really around, systemic thinking, like very logical thinking in training computers to think logically like humans and, you know, to arrive at the answer, if you will, based on that logic. What's so new and exciting about the AI of today is generative AI. And what's unique about generative AI is it's creative. It can generate its own ideas. Everything from novel text to novel images to novel video. At this point, it feels like sky's the limit. So generative AI in HR, which I think is really what we're talking about here, is exciting because there is so much within the HR business process that can be cumbersome, that can be manual, that can be challenging to get individuals, whether they're individual contributors in a company or they're managers or leaders, to engage in some of these processes that maybe in the past have felt a bit labor intensive. And so there's really this opportunity to leverage generative AI in HR business processes that make these processes much more efficient for individuals. One of the things that's exciting for HR professionals right now is that, yes, there's a lot of pressure. We're seeing that every CEO is asking, what are you doing with AI in your teams? So everyone's feeling the pressure and probably feeling a little behind the eight ball when it comes to AI adoption for themselves, AI adoption within their departments and, you know, within their companies. But the reality is at this point is that all of the vendors in the space, you name it, there is a ubiquitous adoption of generative AI within the HR technology space in different ways and very compelling ways. But a lot of the power of Gen AI is being brought to you as an HR professional through the technology that you already use. So you don't necessarily have to do anything markedly different other than be curious. There's pretty much always a war for talent and predicted labor shortages that are going to be facing many industries. So that isn't going to stop. And that's where I find that a lot of the AI and really advanced technology capabilities are introduced first, just because it's so compelling. And there's such a connection between attracting talent and the bottom line for your business that you're going to get the budget. Right. So you often see that folks in the talent acquisition space are going to have maybe bigger budgets to go in and buy advanced technology that's going to help drive effectiveness. And maybe other parts of the HR landscape haven't really been as supported as well as that space. Things like workforce planning, learning and development, even skills development, as we see and we continue to see. What's exciting about now, and in particular with generative AI, is we're able to bring artificial intelligence and really powerful technology into individual business processes and to benefit individual users in a way that I think wasn't doable in the past. I am extremely excited about what generative AI is going to bring to performance management. Performance management is really a human-to-human process, and we don't want the machine to replace the human-to-human process. We want the machine to help aid that process in even being more effective. We all spend a lot of time at work. I believe fundamentally it should be an experience of growth and development. So I'm excited about how we can leverage generative AI to really create an experience for employees that's very, very engaging, that's very valuable. And now we have the opportunity to really build tools that, one, empower individuals to drive their career in really meaningful, powerful ways just through all this data and information, as well as giving leaders an opportunity to look inside their organization in a deeper way for talent, especially with big, large global enterprises. That person who might be a good fit for a role might be in another country or in another division. One of the topics that comes up a lot when you're talking about generative AI, in particular in HR processes and especially in performance processes, is bias. The fact of the matter is these algorithms are trained on content created by human beings. Human beings are, you know, naturally biased, as studies have shown. And so there's going to be some risk of that. One of the things we really take care is to make sure that we're not leaving any major decision to generative AI. You absolutely need a human that is going to take accountability to say, this is my decision. I take ownership of this decision. The second thing that I found is the impact of bias starts to kind of dissipate the more diversity of thought and opinion you have involved in a particular decision. And it's not that any group is any better than the other. It is around bringing together diversity of experience, of thought, of thinking. And it can feel like a really challenging process, but it is exactly that that ensures a great decision ultimately for the company. We've seen attitudes really start to shift. As we talk with customers around their feelings around generative AI, we have gone from real fear and hesitancy, I would say last year, to a lot more acceptance and willingness to experiment, or even just willingness to adopt. I think a lot of it just had to do with the way generative AI kind of hit the scene. It hit the scene in a way that was like very sudden, and there were some pretty major security gaps. And I think some of those early missteps are what set people back a bit, which is completely understanding. So definitely as you are adopting artificial intelligence within your organization, you need to ask those same questions of the vendors you work with that you would for any solution. You know, how are you taking care of privacy? How are you taking care of confidentiality? You know, compliance to the many regulations. And then your vendors should have strong answers for those things.